Hey everyone, it's Justin here, and welcome to your algebra course. We are going to learn so much together in this class, and I just can't wait to get started. So, you might be thinking to yourself, okay, Justin, I'm ready to learn and everything, but what exactly is algebra, and why does it sound like you're getting really excited about math? Well, you see, algebra is the branch of mathematics where we apply math to real-life situations in order to better understand the world around us. In this course, we're going to be building our fundamental algebra skills so that we can take a look at three different types of functions: linear functions, exponential functions, and quadratic functions. Let's explain what all that means. Linear functions are ways we can model real-life scenarios where things change in steady and constant rates. For example, let's say that you just got hired as a chef and you are going to be paid $10 an hour. We can model how much money you're going to make with a line on a graph, because we know you're going to be making $10 every hour. We're going to be looking at lots more linear functions in this course, and we'll even take a look at all the different ways we can represent them. The second type of function we're going to be learning about is the exponential function. This is a function we can use to model scenarios where things change more and more rapidly as time goes on. Say we have a petri dish with a colony of 50 bacteria in it. Each bacteria separates into two new bacteria every hour. So after the first hour, the 50 bacteria would split into 50 new bacteria, leading to 100 total. But we wouldn't be getting 50 bacteria every hour. No, the amount of bacteria in the petri dish would double every hour. So this colony is going to get really big really quickly. You can see that this graph has a curve that gets steeper and steeper as time goes on. As you might have guessed from that example, exponential functions are used a lot in science, but they also show up a lot in my favorite subject, money. The final type of equation we'll be looking at in this course is the quadratic function. Are there any real-world situations that you think we could model with this shape? To me, this looks like a ball flying through the air. Maybe we could use this to model the path of a fly ball in baseball, or a football after you kick a field goal. It also kind of reminds me of the path a ski jumper takes when they take off, or that a high jumper takes in track and field. There's a reason I'm giving a lot of sports examples of quadratic functions. It's because they're commonly used to model motion. Now that we've talked about what you're going to be learning, let's talk about how we're going to be learning it. Most of your algebra lessons will have three major components: the PDF, the video lesson, which is what you're watching right now, and the practice game. The PDF is actually the first thing you should use for every lesson. You should actually be using it right now. Before you started this video, you should have opened the PDF for this lesson. That looks something like this. If you want to make the most out of your PDFs, you're going to have to be able to write on them. You can use an editing program on your device, or you can print out the PDF and physically write on it. If you don't have the PDF for this lesson in front of you, that's totally fine. Pause the video here and get it now. One of the best parts of your PDF will be the student checklist. This is a list of tasks that you'll be completing for each lesson. For example, you'll see that the student checklist for this lesson has you watching this video lesson, great job, taking some guided notes, and completing a practice game. Every PDF will also have guided notes for each lesson. You should be filling these guided notes out as you're watching the video. The guided notes will help you organize and keep track of all of the key information you'll be learning so that you can review it later when you need to. It'll also have activities and learning opportunities that are crucial for your understanding of the lessons. So to make the most out of this course, be sure that you're completing the student checklists and the guided notes. Most of your lessons will have a video that goes along with it, just like this one. In these videos, I'll give you some instructions and we'll complete some example problems together. Always make sure that you have your PDF open while you're watching the video so that you can take your notes as you go. At the end of your lessons, there will be a practice game. The practice game is a perfect opportunity to do just that, practice what you learned. Remember, these practice games are a learning opportunity. It's not a test. It's totally okay to make mistakes on the practice game as long as you're learning from them. If you ever find yourself struggling with a particular practice game, then that might be a sign that it's a good idea to rewatch the video or go back and check your notes to make sure that they're accurate. Your trusted adult will have an answer key to your PDFs too. So if you ever find something a little too hard, you can always ask them to check your work with you. All right, now that you know what to expect, let's dive into some algebra. Remember to download and open up the PDF for our next lesson before you start it. I can't wait to start your algebra course with you, and I'll see you next time.